Nope.
Everybody's out
there. We make the strings louder.
Alright, so the camera's not zoomed in all on my face and beard, my new face and beard, but doing a few things on that thing, wastegate actuator install, you'll see that, that's a big pain in the ass, but that's besides the point. I'm not sure when you'll see that video, but here we are, we got the S14, just got back from the drift event, last week, but this week is No Coast, drift party down in Albuquerque, New Mexico, and so it is Friday at 5, almost 6 p.m. The plan is to not really do much to it because it doesn't really need much done to it. So I'm going to go ahead and when I was doing some donuts and stuff, if you guys have been on my Snapchat, I did like this little rap video thing and I was drifting around this dude while he's rapping. But anyhow, the diff got hot and it started kind of puking oil out of the little deal, so I think it needs a little bit of diff fluid. So I'm going to check that, or maybe I'll just bring it with me and add some when we get there. Or maybe I'll do it now, I don't know. But yeah, when I was filming the little thing, I put my old bumper back on it on account of I ripped this one off and then I left the other chunk of the track. So I had this one on there, which I don't like this one because it doesn't match the kit. This is like an AIT Racing, so it's like pointy and then that kind of like tapers off and I like that. And then, you know, that other bumper actually matched. So anyhow, hit the wall doing that. So, you know, my car's getting basically uglier as the season goes, but that's exactly why I haven't refreshed it, because I was just like, well, you know, I'll just drive and have fun with it instead of spending all kinds of time stressing out trying to make it pretty. But yeah, so kind of basically after No Coast, there's one more event in Colorado for the competition series, and then after that, then we're pretty much done for the season as far as Colorado. They might do one more like little drift bash thing the end of the year, but as far as I know, that's pretty much it. I would like to make it down to Texas for one of their events at Mineral Wells before the end of the season. But yeah, basically it's gonna be No Coast, Colorado, and then hopefully a Texas event, and then that should be it for the end of the season. So my buddy's on the way over here right now. He has some tires. I used up a lot at the last Colorado event, which you guys seen. But yeah, so I got all my wheels over there, they're all dismounted and everything pretty much ready to go. So all he's got to do is show up here. We're gonna go ahead and load them up and then head down there. So that's the plan. All right, so I got shit loaded up. You see cars on the thing. I got Tetris and shit in here as best as I can. So I got six wheels of tires in there, a spare trailer tire, another spare trailer tire, jack ramps, chairs, two tents. Now I just gotta load up my tools and stuff and decide if I'm gonna bring the extra pair of, well, I have four new tires that I haven't had mounted yet.
What, dude?
So I'm not sure if I should do what?
The freaking Cummins got 16.2 miles per gallon.
No way.
With a towing trip.
With a tow in there. Fuck, should I get a Cummins? Should I just sell it? Big Dirty and get, no.
No, don't sell Big Dirty, it's too low.
It's too good to me, huh? Okay, but yeah, that's getting ready to load up. I don't know. So we're about 2 hours and 45 minutes in. We got about another 2 hours and 20 minutes to go. 159 miles until we're at the track, which you guys probably can't see me. Hold on. Ah! Look at that. Now you can see me, probably. But got Jesse over here. What are you eating?
Some fucking dark chocolate almonds.
Oh, you fucker, don't eat all those. You bastard. No, I should have got the big bag. We went to Walmart on the way, like getting ready to leave town, and I was like, I forgot that Jesse was coming with me. Because, like, no matter what, like, it's like double. Like, if I have like one portion of something, like, Jesse eats like twice as much. And, like, this is like the dude that, like, he'll get a pizza, like, squirt some ranch on it, fold it in half, and eat the son of a bitch. Like, like a big pizza, like, taco. Like, that's Jesse, you know? But, anyhow, so we're just cruising on along. one of my subscriber homies Snapchatted me and told me, because I on my Snapchat I said I'm coming to Albuquerque to go to the No Coast. He's like, dude, no way. So I was just giving him shit about his username. It was like some sexy beast or some shit. So I told him I can't wait to meet the sexy beast tomorrow. So looking forward to the sexy beast. Hopefully, do you think he's gonna show up?
Oh, dude, I know. Knowing your subscribers, dude, they'll come get you.
Yeah, it looks weird in here. It's like we're like filming like the fucking Blair Witch Project or some shit.
You're drinking this
like
any form of stimulus that is in a beverage form.
Yeah. All right, so we're out here, No Coast 2016.
That green and tan cooler in the back of the Dodge. Hello.
What are you drinking today?
Now, dude.
This is a Toro Rojo.
Oh, that was the opposite imported thing that you were drinking last night. So I got here like 2 in the morning, and this motherfucker just comes stumbling up to my
drinking
shit.
Water and shit.
Yeah, drinking all kinds of water.
Yeah, you got your cart doing.
Yeah, yeah.
Tim's is
in that green and gray cooler in the bed.
How's it feel to be a burly boy?
It feels pretty burly, honestly.
How's the front of your car after the wall?
Probably. It's a front end now.
It's not doing too bad.
We'll see. It might break.
And then you ruined your homie's trailer.
Yeah.
With a strap on it. That's terrible.
Throw over the strap, blew it up.
And so Joe came down. So we're getting ready to go. We're getting ready to go to the driver's meeting right now. But yeah, it's like 9 o'clock. Woke up at like 8. Big Dirty's the current home for this little adventure. And but yeah, the car's still here. We had some sausage patties when we woke up, some iced coffee so we don't get a fucking headache. Joe, what are you doing?
Getting ready for the driver's meeting.
Why? Who's going to win today?
We're all going to win today.
Everybody's going to win today.
We're all winning.
Yeah, because we're all winners. Because it's not a... Hey, what kind of e-brake is that? China?
Terrorist e-brake.
Oh, it's the... Ooh. But I don't even... 235s. Wow. Do you like these?
Are you KR30s?
No, how are they?
I haven't. I'm going to find out.
Guess what I'm on today?
Jesse's tires.
Yeah, we're going to see how they do. Hopefully. I don't know. Oh, look at that thing.
Doggo.
Hey, what are you driving here today?
Huh?
What are you driving here today?
Kieran's car.
Who's Kieran?
White Escort.
Didn't you just meet him?
I've known him for a long time.
Oh, okay. Somebody else just met him. They're like, there's this Kieran guy that I just met, and he's driving his shit.
I just met him.
What are you doing today?
I'm trying to wake up.
Nice. How's your other car? So Corey, this is my buddy Corey. We're throwing you on the Motion on TV, bud. So he has how many swaps have you done in the last year?
JZ, RB, and LS.
So the 1J that's currently in my S13
was in my car.
It was in his car. And it blew up the turbo, and then he's like, "Fuck that
this,
shit."
Done.
Sold it. Some other guy got it, and then I ended up getting from him because he like was getting, he was adulting and shit. So now, yeah. And now it runs just fucking perfect. Oh, no, it's one of our other buddies
over there somewhere.
He has a beard.
He's got a beard and
stuff. But yeah, so Corey, and you still haven't driven the fucker this year.
No.
So he has a Turbo LS, Turbo 5.3, but he thinks he rod knocked it fucking driving around the block. Because yeah. it was a previously Danny. It was previously Danny'd.
Danny'd. Brian Crafted.
Previously Danny'd. And I've established, remember that SR that you guys were trying to sell?
Yeah.
I was like, anything previously Danny'd, I'm kind of like
scared.
See,
that's
about.
Why I keep messing up. I buy engines from Danny and Wes.
Danny and Wes. You just need to buy something from me. I do some decent shit.
Sell me your 6.0.
Oh, yeah. Well, that's because I need that eventually. Because I want to do the Turbo 6.0. We should probably go to the driver's meeting, eh? Uh-oh.
Bud!
What happened? I'm curious to try them, maybe. Or look at them, or something.
You want to pay for them?
I don't want to pay for them, no.
You want to pay for them?
A little bit of the pit walk. Here's another homie from the Texas side of things.
Dude, so dope.
We got Super Duty, but I need one of those. Look at that.
What?
Fuck. Whose is that?
I don't know.
That's a Texas guy.
Look at that.
Let's go Lone Star Drift. I wonder, what if Aaron just showed up?
Probably not. Oh my. He ain't gonna lie.
Hey Dan, I forgot all my money today, so can I drive for free? Probably. It's the No Coast Drift Party.
He's off.
Dan!
What?
That's terrible.
Everybody always forgets their money. It's weird.
Yeah.
Shorts.
Bark!
The dog's just shit. So the car's doing pretty good. It's right now we're just doing like a little, almost getting ready to do a little break. I went through basically two complete sets. I mean, it's kind of murdering these things. Like that's e-brake. Right here you can see actual big chunks, and that's how you know you're actually baking the shit out of them is when they do that. But yeah, they're basically slicks right now. Been getting about like 8 to 10 runs on a pair of them, maybe a little bit more than that. But they're not doing too bad. I mean, especially for the price difference and availability, and I mean they don't have as much grip as these, but I mean for the price wise and getting them last minute, they're not bad. So they're actually doing like a little top 16 competition here today, which isn't going to be super super crazy or anything. Yeah, so they're going to set up the competition course. But I basically only have two pair of tires left. If you guys are into the whole drifting thing or in Pro-Am or into driving or anything, you guys have probably seen like the Zestino tires. They're out here today, so I was gonna see, they're selling them. So I was gonna maybe buy a pair of those just to see. I know they have a driver program.
Why'd you take your canopies down?
Because they're gonna blow away.
Oh, was it getting nasty out here?
Yeah. What are we getting ready? Tell them what we're getting ready to do. We're doing a tandem competition.
Are we?
And at No Coast, we're doing like a top 16, I think.
Yeah.
So everybody's lining up because it's 6 o'clock, and then we're gonna do one run, and then just basically a little top 16. So we're gonna do that. I think Jesse's gonna try to get some video of it. He's gonna try. Hopefully me and Joe go up against each other.
First round, so I can knock you out.
I can fuck him up again, eh?
I can get redemption.
I can fuck him up again.
I wanna beat you and get redemption.
And don't fucking say that
shit.
Don't
make me pipping over you.
No, I don't wanna hear any of that. But yeah, so here's the camera, bud.
All right, dude.
Driver, he's driving a very good looking car as well. Not making a whole ton of horsepower, but very, very well. Swinging it in, stalling on throttle. Heading out to that zone, filling it all the way up. Actually, past the cone. Good transition through there. Tons and tons of smoke for you guys. Smoking those Destino tires. A little bit of dirt drop. Hanging it out towards the wall.
Everybody's outside. They're tearing some shit apart.
What? Wherever they're trying to, I think they're trying to change tires or something. Make sure it's all locked up, or not locked up, but it's sealed, except for probably gonna get shit in the under the bonnet, and it'll probably sputter a little bit. But
yeah, they're over there doing that.
So we just got done with the qualifying. I did a decent run. Right now I'm just sitting here eating some snacks. And it's a bedhead snacks, you know. My mission is the pizzas. But yeah, so I'm just relaxing for a little bit. Eating some shit. Watching everybody run around. I got Big Dirty just chilling here. The AC on, trying to kind of drown myself out. I got them Zestinos all mounted. So we'll see how those are doing here in a little bit. If it dries out.
In this exact section right here, actually switching my bumper and taking
get intense right here.
Wes got first, Brandon second, and then Luke was third.
Just want to let you guys know.
Day two of the No Coast Drift Party. We got Jesse just sleeping his ass off in the front seat of my truck. I had the back seat. Big Dirty came in handy, you know, like always. Getting ready to throw on these new tires. Go out and have a little bit more fun. I just finished off the last of my tires that I was on last night for the tandem competition or whatever. They're getting ready to do a team tandem type of thing. But Wes, the other guy who's going to be on the team, he's not here. He's at his hotel sleeping and shit. So I'm going to go ahead and throw these things on and then we'll do some more laps. Maybe find another partner because he's gone. Comparison, like the Nankings, the 275 Nankings that have been running, they're 350, and then these other little 245 tires, they're at 300 and something, 340 tread wear. So that's why these ones are expensive, really heavy. I mean, you can just tell the compound is just like interesting. So I'm assuming like for the first like warm up, they're gonna be super slick, and then after that, it's gonna break my diff and shit. So hopefully. What do you think they're gonna do?
I think they'll be like Achilles, pretty much.
Basically an Achilles, yeah. That's what people are comparing them to. But they're trying to go to FD. There's all kinds of hype on the internet about these things. So I decided to test it out. Or test them out and see how they are.
Thank you.
so that was the first little test run with the Zestinos. Dude, I only got, was that three laps?
Yeah.
I mean, I'm gonna go to the other side and show them the other one. Well, you can't really see it because it's moving right now, but shit, I mean, it's probably 80% done at least. Felt like I had a shitload of grip. I mean, not a crazy amount. I mean, it wasn't like I had to fight it. They are at like 50 PSI right now. Felt like I definitely had a little bit more, ability to kind of catch up, and the car didn't want to float as much, like off track, kind of. So I was able to kind of close the gap a little bit on him. Felt like they made a shitload of smoke, and it's kind of weird. They have, it smells like old Taco Bell, like the smoke. Yeah, it's a really interesting, smell that the smoke comes off of it. You guys ever been to a drift event? You can kind of tell the difference in tires sometimes by, like, the way, how they smell. This is basically like, you got old Taco Bell, you got a soft taco with lettuce and all that shit. You sat it in your fridge and then pulled it out the next day and smelled it. That's exactly what these tires smell like when they're burning. So kind of sucks though, because they don't really last that long. Like, that was three laps and they're done, so. We're back at the shop now, got everything all unloaded. That's one of the, like I say probably almost every time, is that's one of the shittiest things about going to drift events, is all the effort that you have to put in it to, you know, loading all the shit and unloading all the shit, and then, you know, unloading it at the track and then reloading it. But so this is what happened on the track on my last run, is basically this tow arm in the back, you can see it ripped the welds out. There's like a little drop off with like a little 90 degree that I kind of hit, dropped off there and did that, and then it was rubbing on my lower control arm. You can see right there when I was, you know, pulling it on and off the trailer, so it's got like this little trail of like slivers as I was pulling in the shop. The car did absolutely amazing. I couldn't really have asked for any better. I really wish, you know, The tires would have lasted a little bit longer at the event, but I guess, you know, 10 or so laps on a pair of cheap tires isn't too bad, and they didn't delaminate or do anything crazy. Met a couple of you guys there too. I think it was about 5 or 6, subscribers came up and talked to me, so that was pretty cool. So thanks for you guys coming out and checking out the car and saying what's up. So I think that's going to do it for this video. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. I think I'll probably be at the No Coast next year, hopefully. And, you know, on to some more drifting here in Colorado. I think there's one more event and then like a bash and then that'll be it. But